It's time to praise the Lord. Let us pray. Father, we are grateful that you have given us another day, indeed another week. And we declare this is the week of the devil's defeat. We will rejoice and be glad in it. And so let the words of my mouth and the meditation of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my Redeemer. Amen. 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 I trust that you're doing well with your families and enjoying this time of lockdown. Indeed, God is faithful to us as believers. And today, and this week, as we continue to battle this pandemic as believers, we want to challenge us to work diligently to manifest the spiritual life that God will be praised in our living. Manifestation of this spiritual life is not predicated on our positions, titles, or earthly possessions. The only way we can manifest this spiritual life is to follow Paul's encouragement to the Galatian saints in chapter 5, verse 22 to 23, and we title this the fruit of the Spirit. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, meekness, temperance. And I love this part, against such there is no law. We will explore each bite of the fruit during these devotion time this week. And I want to encourage families to have devotions on each part of the fruit of the Spirit towards building up each other in the most holy faith. On today, we're going to share about love, the agape love. And love is an attribute of God because God is love. Hence, we cannot have agape love outside of God. Jesus was calling Peter to leadership. He was teaching him about love. And he asked Peter very, very simply, "Do you love me more than these?" And Peter responded, "Yes, Lord, I love thee." But Peter's love was one of phileo and not agape. Jesus was teaching him the love that he needs to have as a servant of the Most High God. And that is what he wants to teach us during this week and for the rest of our lives, that we need to have the love, the unconditional love, manifesting in our lives as we live during these times, specifically these times of pandemic. You see, the love that Peter responded with was one of affection. And God wants us to go beyond just an affectionate kind of love. He wants us to have the agape love. This love God is demanding from believers. He wants us to manifest love without conditions. We must have love one to another. It must flow. It's not one for another where someone has to earn it, but rather love to another. One way we can manifest that in this season is that we need to be patient with one another, kind. We need to manifest long-suffering. Yes, the spaces are getting small because we are locked down. But if you have the love of God, the agape love of God, we will be patient, kind to one another in our homes. And this will extend itself to others because we are practicing it with one another, with our near ones. I want to encourage us to manifest this love. Chew on this part of the fruit of the Spirit during this day and show one another patience and kindness. More importantly, I want to encourage families to devote themselves this week in particular, and let's bite on these 9 parts of the fruit of the Spirit. Let's chew on them. Let's find ourselves talking about love today. How we can express our love one to another. And then just check it. If we find ourselves doing otherwise, then we need to repent. We need to say, I'm sorry. Because the opposite of love is hate. And this Paul also taught in Galatians 5. Encourage us to guard with love this week. The love that Jesus demands of us. The agape love. Now abided faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Let's bite on it. Let's chew on it. Let's live it out. God loves us, and we need to love one another. Let us pray. Father, thank you for the example that you've given to us. For you love us so that you gave your only begotten Son. And in this lesson, you teach us that we need to have the agape love, the love without condition, the love that Christ did for us. And we need to focus on this week, this day, so that we may overcome the enemy of our minds that is bringing fear upon us. And we come against this pandemic. We come against this pandemic. We call it for what it is. It is a principality. And the body of Christ come against this principality in the name of Jesus. We will not fear, hallelujah. We will not be intimidated. And so I pray for the governments of the world, the leaders of the world. I pray for the body of Christ in particular today. Also those who lead in the medical profession. God, that we will let love be manifested in us. We will not fear, hallelujah. We will not give this pandemic no more life, but we will indeed declare, hallelujah, that we come against this pandemic. We come against this principality, this power of the air. We come against it in the name of Jesus. And we praise you that we are overcomers because we have not fear, but we have love. In the name of the Father, in the name of the Son, in the name of the Holy Spirit. Amen. So as we go through this week with the love of God, we say to this principality, God is greater. His love is greater in Jesus' name. Have a blessed day. And remember, spend time with your family and devote in prayer, in reading of the Word, and then focusing on the love of God. Have a lovable day. God bless you.